Good morning, well, at Leston, during the week, we have seen the beginning of the theory of linear algebra, the vector spaces, the vectors, the linearly dependent and independent set of vectors. Next Monday, we shall end the theorems about the linear dependent and all independent sets. But the study, whether a set of vectors satisfies the condition of linearly dependent or linear independence, can be studied through the analytic instrument based on linear systems. For this reason, I would say to recall, to do a short overview about the linear systems. At lesson, we saw how to obtain a linear system, how a linear system arises from a vector equation. Component by component, the equality between two vectors can be reduced to the n equalities between the corresponding components in the left hand side and in the right hand side. Two vectors are equal if and only if they have all components corresponding to equal. Yeah. Well, from the vector equation, we arrive at a scalar system. We arrive at scalar equations forming a linear system. A linear system is then can be written A1x1 plus A2x2 plus A3x3 plus dots AnxN equal P1. The second equation will be A1x1 plus A2x2 plus A3x3 plus dot AnxN equal P2. We can recognize at this point that the second equation is equal to the first equation. In general, A1. But in general, the equations are different from each other. How can we distinguish the two equations? Either we use different letters, but if the letters are several, I should use the whole alphabet, or I use one letter only and introduce the indices, which are most convenient in this frame. Now we have to take into account, for example, that the first row refers to the first equation. The second index has to make understand that this is the first equation. And then we have an index one, a second index always one. In the first equation, then always two in the second equation, and so on. So the first coefficient, there is no problem because we have A11. The problem arises from the second in the first equation, from the second coefficient on. That is, let's consider this term. A2x2. Two will write 1A12 X2 or A21 X2 A12 In other words, we adopt the convention according to which the index of the unknown is equal to the second index of the coefficient. We decide this convention. We choose this convention. This convention is coherent, is in agreement with other conventions about the matrices in the next topics, in the next parts of the program. And then I have left the space on the left, one. I repeat the convention, the index of the unknowns is always coincident with the second index of the coefficient. In principle, it could be equal also to the first index, but we choose the nearest indices to be equal. And then I cancel here. Now, in the second equation, we shall have 8-1, 2-2, 2-3, 2n. Dots, vertical dots, A, M1. X1 plus A M2 X2 plus A M3 X3 plus A M XN equal PM. The index of P of the left of the right hand side is always coincident with the first index of the coefficient A. I want to anticipate this notation, this more compact notation, but since it is more compact, it could be a little more difficult. Instead of writing the equation in this form, pay attention to the convention. The index of the unknowns is always equal to the second index of A. The index of the right-hand side B, B1, B2, Bn, is always equal to the common first index of the first of the coefficients in the same equation. And then, if you have studied statistics in the first level degree, you will agree that all the system could be denoted by this notation. Sum of AX equal B. Let's observe the sum. In every equation, the sum is always 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus n in the between the second index on the second index of A and the index of X in every equation. The index of B, I can write Bj, but and then sum over E between 1 and N. I from 1 to N. What must I write here? It's simple. Just the index of B is coincident with the first index of A. And then I write J. And then 1 plus 2 plus 3 and so on. Is sum over I, that is A, J, I, X, I, comma, for J, tell me the range of J. J is the index of B, for example, or the first index of A. J, the first index of A, runs over 1, 2, 3, M. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, dot M. 1, 2, 3, M. J equal 1, 2, 3, dot M. I run from 1 to N. J from 1 to M. We can recognize the more compactness or compactness of this location. Since the range over which an index runs is very often deducible from the context, one could also write so without sigma. Only this, still more compact. This is called when I omit sigma, one says that I am using, do you know the name? Einstein's convention prescribes every time you see a repeated index, a double index, over this index there is a sum. Sigma, we need sigma only to denote the sum. Sum over I. But the sum over I can be recognized because I and I are two equal indices. And that's why Einstein convention is powerful when we have many pairs of equal indices. If we have with many pairs, some of the I, some of the J, some of the K, some of the H, the formula would assume heavy form. And then one can omit the symbols of sum, the symbols of sigma.
Professore.
If only one sum, there is no great difference.
Professore.
Okay. We don't need this more compact notation now, but in the future, about the linear applications, it could be convenient, even if also in that frame, and if it should create confusion, we shall hold it also in that context. Today, for the last instance, it doesn't play a great role. I have only taken the occasion to present you this notation, but we don't use this notation. I cancel, and then I cancel here. Well, this is the form under which a linear switch is better writing. We have to associate to the linear system two matrices. Matrix A, A11, A12, A13, A1n, A21, A22, A23, dots A2n, vertical dots AM1, AM2, AM3, dots AMN. This is the matrix A, capital A, the first matrix. The first matrix. The matrix B is equal matrix A. I should copy the matrix A to which I add B1, B2, Bm. This is the matrix B. We could draw here a line, it's not important. This is the matrix. Now we pass to concrete numbers and abandon A11, A12, when it is not necessary. This is to introduce, only to introduce the formal theory.
In the second matrix, we write the matrix A and we add the B1.
The column of the right hand side. We add the columns of the constants. These are called the constants, termini not. Now we have to study to determine the rank of the matrix A and the rank of the matrix B. The rank.
Sorry, what about the X?
No, in the matrices we write the coefficients only. The coefficients only. The system has the unknowns, but the solutions depend on the coefficients only. Cramer's rule and all that. We have to determine the rank of a matrix, of a single matrix. The rank of the matrix A, the rank of the matrix B. In principle, the two ranks are independent from each other. But obviously, in some cases, sometimes, the information of A can be generated by the matrix B. In other words, the rank of B is sometimes directly related to the rank A without repeating the calculations for the rank also for B. We deduce the rank of B from the structure of B itself and from what we have already computed, from what we have computed about A. Okay, this is the deal. Then, after one has determined the ranks, both ranks, we do the comparison for applying the Shekabedi's theorem and then the Cramer's rule. These are the steps. Now, to present the procedure directly, I cancel this general form, and we focus on concrete cases. Concrete cases, because it is inconvenient to give the rule, to show the procedure, the theory, the method, by writing the dots. We proceed directly on concrete cases, but this is it is fast for all to notice that this is anyway without the rule of general. We have to compute the rank of the matrices, of both matrices. What is the rank? The rank of the matrix, of a matrix, depends on the so-called minor matrices contained in the matrix itself. What is a minor matrix?
Like
A1, A2, and A1. No, I write the concrete numbers. I append all the notation A11, A12. It is important to have pointed out that the second index of the coefficient is equal to the index of the unknown. This is important in the future. But now, for solving only for solving the system, that abstract notation does not play an essential role. When we have to study to define and to determine, first to define first, the rank of a matrix. Let's consider a matrix A equal. A matrix contains numbers 3, minus 4, 1, minus 1, negative 1, 2, negative 2, 5, 0, 4, 1, negative 3, 4. A generic matrix. A minor matrix inside the given matrix is a matrix having the elements, the common elements contained, the common elements contained in K rows and K columns. In other words, we choose an equal number of rows and columns in the matrix. The number of rows and of columns must be equal. And then it must be coherent, compatible with the elements contained in the matrix itself. What does it mean? In this matrix, for example, I can choose one row and one column, two rows and two columns, three rows and three columns, but I cannot choose four rows and four columns because there are not four rows. There are four columns, but since I have to choose an equal number of rows and columns, I cannot go over three rows and three columns. This is the first step. I choose an equal number of rows, an equal possible number of rows and columns. Then, if the choice has no ambiguity, I have not to choose anything else. If the choice has an ambiguity, I have to specify the choice. If I choose, for example, three rows and three columns, three rows have no ambiguity because the matrix has only three rows. If I choose three rows, the three rows are all the rows of the matrix itself. But three rows and three columns, for the three columns, I have to specify the choice. So the matrix has four columns. Three columns, but which three columns? Which three columns? For example, this choice, first, second, and third column. If I choose three rows, the three rows of the matrix, and three columns, these three columns, what are the common elements to these choices? I extract the common elements to the three rows and the first three columns, and I can write 3, -4, 1, two, negative two, five, four, one, negative three. This is called one. Major matrix of the matrix A, a major matrix of order three. Of order three, because it is the consequence of the choice of three rows and three columns. It is not unique. It is not the unique minor matrix of order three, because I could choose always three rows. About the three rows, there is no ambiguity. But other three columns, for example, I could do this choice. In this case, the minor matrix is the matrix containing, formed by the common elements to the rows and the columns that we have chosen. 3, negative 4, negative 1, 2, negative 2, 0, 4, 1, 4. This is another minor matrix of order 3. Every minor matrix corresponds to a particular choice of rows and columns. It is not important how many the minor matrices of the given order are. If the number of minor is easy to be seen, we could count the minor matrices. The minor matrices. Not important the formula to count them. For example, how many minor matrices of order 3 are contained here inside? This was the first. This is the second, the third, and the fourth minor matrix of order 3. You can see that the A has four minor matrices of order 3. Then we have the minor matrices of order 2. The minor matrices of order 2 come from the choice of two rows and two columns. If we choose two rows and two columns, we have ambiguity about the rows as well as about the columns. If I say two rows, the rows are three. Which two rows we have to choose? And then, for example, I can choose first and third column. First, the second and third row. What are the common elements? The common elements to this choice? They are 2, 4 and 5, negative 3. Okay. How many minor matrices of order 2 are contained in capital A? What is the formula? The formula is not important. Have you ever seen this symbol in statistics and probability? This symbol, N over K? Binomial factor, Newton's binomial factor is called. What is its definition? Factorial of N over factorial of K, but not only. Otherwise, there would not be need to use n over k, but directly n factorial m of n over factorial k. At the numerator, we have the factorial of the number epoch. At the denominator, we have two factorials of the number below, and then factorial of the difference, n minus k. What is the rule of the factorial? All factorials equal. 1 times 2 times 3 times 4. 3 factorial equal 1 times 2 times 3. 2 factorial equal 1 times 2. 1 factorial equal 1. 0 factorial. What is 0 factorial? It must be coherent with that rule in mathematics. So is the extension. What can we say? From a factorial to the next one, we divide, we eliminate the last term, the last factor. 3 factorial is 4 factorial over 4. 4 factorial divided by 4, I cancel 4 and 4, and we get 1, 2, 3. Okay? This is the rule of the factorial. If you apply that rule to 0 factorial, it's 1. 0 factorial equals 3, 4, 4, 7, 8, 8, 0, 1, 1. And above, I write the factorial. 0 factorial is 1 factorial over 1. 1 factorial is 1. Over 1 is 1. The logic is the same as if you consider 2, 3 to 0 equal, y 3 to 0 is 1. 3 to 0 is 1. Why? Because 3 cubed is 3 times 3 times 3. 3 squared equals 3 times 3. 3 to 1 equals 3. Every time. Every time we divide by 3. Divide by 3, we get 3 times 3. Divided by 3, we get 3. While the exponent descends by every time by a unit, 3, 2, 1, here we have to divide on the right hand side. Divided by 3, we get this one. Divided by 3, we get this one. Divided by 3, 3. Divided by 3, equal 1. The logic of the properties. Okay. And then I cancel the power because it is already known. I cancel here. We have obtained the rule for 0 factorial, and then Now we can apply, we can compute all binomial factors. Now, what is the rule of binomial? We know that one factorial of zero is always one. I cancel here. Now, the number of marginal matrices. Of a given order K inside the matrix having m rows, according the notation of before, the previous notation, having m rows and n columns is m rows, n columns. What is the number of the minor matrices of a given order K? Is the product, the ordinary product, between two binomial factors. n over k. This is the formula. It is not important to say because it is very simple. Why are there 18 matrix minus of order 2 here inside? Because we have three rows, four columns. We want to count. We want to count the minus of order 2, of order k. K is below 3 over 2 times 4 over 2 equal. What is 3 over 2? Factorial of 3 over factorial of 2. Difference factorial, 3 minus 2, 1 factorial, times 4 over 2 is 4 factorial of 4 over factorial of 2, and then factorial of the difference, 2 factorial, equal. Factorial of 3 is 6, over factorial of 2 is 2, times 1, times factorial of 4 is 24, 4 times 3, 1 times 2 times 3 times 4, over factorial of 2 is 2, 2 times 2, equal 2 times 2 times 2 is 8, 24. Sorry for the blackboard in front of the camera. I avoid the space. Equal 6, 3 factorial of 3, 6, over 2, times 1, times factorial of 4 is 24, over factorial of 2 is 2, 2 times 2, equal. At the denominator we have 2 times 2 times 2 is 8. It simplifies 8. 24 over 8 is 3. 6 times 3 equals 18. But it is not important the formula, only the first time as the special effect.
So there is someone that wants to participate at the
one?
No, no. Questo c'è qualcuno che vuole partecipare al Dharma.
There is another. Well, we now know what the minor matrices inside the given matrix are. The minor matrices are always square matrices by its nature, because they are defined, they arise from the choice of an equal number of rows and columns inside the matrix. This matrix is called rectangular matrix because it has a different number of rows and columns. When the matrix is rectangular, we have to specify the number of rows and columns. When it is a square matrix, we could say square matrix 3 times 3, 3 rows, 3 columns, or of order 3. One can say shortly, of order 3-2, also of order 3, of order 4, order is related to, associated to, square matrices. The rectangular matrices have different numbers, and then we have to specify the number of rows and columns. Well, now, after what has determined the minors, we have to define and compute the determinant of the minor matrix. We have to define the determinant of a minor matrix. The minor matrix is a square matrix, and then we can say we have to define the determinant of every square matrix. I can set this matrix, and we pass to study, to define and study the determinant of the square matrices. The square matrices, because the determinant is computed of the minor matrices. The minor matrices are only square matrices. And then I can set it. Well, I have answered, but what you say equal 3, 1, -2, 4, 5, -3. Here 3, 7, -2. Obviously, if we choose in a matrix one row and one column, for example, this row, first row, second column, if we choose one row and one column, we shall have a minor matrix of order 1. What is the element? This is the common element. The row and column that we have chosen. And then I can always extract this element. This is the minor matrix of order 1 having the unitary time seven minor matrix that we can extract from the given matrix. There are also the minor matrix of order one. Where, and then, in order to define and to study the determinants of the minor matrix or the square matrix, we have to start from the square matrices of order one. I can say this example, and I start to define the determinant. The determinant will have a different rule for all matrices, but we have to point out the common feature, the common property of all determinants. The rule is unique of the determinant. Different are the applications to the different orders for obvious reasons. But the rule, the concept will be always the same. Matrix of order one. What is the determinant of the matrix of order one? In this case, the determinant of A equals A itself. The unique element in a square matrix of order one, the matrix of order one, the determinant of a matrix of order one, is its unique element itself. The matrix of order one is finished. Now we pass to the matrix of order two. A11, in order to give the rule, I use again the indices for the reasons that will appear clear in a short time. A12, A21, A22. When we have said that the second index, the index of the equation, is in the first place, when we introduced the convention before on the linear system, we deduce consequently that the first index denotes the row, the second index the column. Okay, the convention on the system has this effect on the matrix. Now, what is the determinant? What is the definition of the determinant? The definition of the determinant is this one. The determinant of A in this case, this A of order 2, is so. Since the order is 2, then we multiply A1, A2. We multiply 2 factors A. 2 factors A with the sequence of the natural number A1, A2. If we would have multiplied the 3 factors A, like in the next step, we should have written, A1 times A2 times A3. We shall see data. A1, A2. And then I apply A1, A2. How many A1, A2 do I write? A1, A2, two factors A, because the matrix is of order 2. How many products A1, A2 I write depends on the so-called permutations. We have order 2. I have written here the indices until 2. and then I write here 1, 2. What is the permutation? When we have a sequence of numbers, a permutation is another sequence of the same number, another sequence in which at least, sorry, not at least, in which one pair of near numbers, only two near numbers, are exchanged. Always two near numbers. Here, near numbers is not important because we have only two numbers. Two numbers are obviously near. But if we consider a sequence of five numbers, we have many pairs of numbers. In order to obtain the permutation, we can exchange only a pair of two near numbers. We shall see in the next step. Or if you want, if we have 3, 2, 1, 4, 5, these are five numbers. It's not a vector, eh? A vector has nothing to do here. I want to obtain another permutation. I consider two near numbers, for example, these two near numbers, and then we pass from this sequence to this other sequence. 3, 2, 4, 1, 5. Now we can choose another permutation here. We can exchange 3, 2, always to near numbers. Okay. For now, we are interested on or in 1, 2. These examples are only to anticipate the next steps. Okay. Cancel. Here. What is another permutation of 1, 2, 2, 1? Is there another permutation? No. Another different permutation? No. If we exchange 2, 1, we obtain again 1, 2. For every given order, we write the natural sequence starting from 1, 1, 2, 3 until the order. Order 2, only 1, 2. And then we have to write all possible permutations of the sequence 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3 until the order. After we have all permutations, we count them. Two permutations, and then two permutations leads to two products, A1, A2. Okay. A1, A2, the product is between two factors, because the order, the number of factors, is the order of the matrix. The number of product is equal to the number of permutation. Okay. Now we are finished to write down the final determinant, what must we write here again? The second indices and the coefficient of the linear of the algebraic sum. Okay. The second indices are given by the permutation. The coefficients are only positive 1 or negative 1. positive one if the permutation written as second indices is an even permutation. Negative one if the permutation that I write here as second indices is an odd permutation. What does it mean? What does odd, even or odd permutation mean? A permutation is even or odd or ever, even or odd, if the number of changes starting from the fundamental permutation, obtaining that permutation, that particular permutation, is an even or odd number. The permutation is even if we have done an even number of exchanges between two near numbers, or an odd number of exchanges. The first permutation, called the fundamental permutation, according the natural sequence, is always even. Why? Because the first permutation has been obtained, has been written with zero permutation exchanges. Zero is an even number. Okay? This permutation is odd because it has been obtained through one exchange. One is an odd number. Okay? And now, here I write 1, 2 as second indices. 1, 2. Here I write 2, 1. And then here plus 1, because 1, 2 is an even permutation. Before the even is plus 1. Here, negative. Negative 1, I don't write 1. I break the record for the record not to be too long for the upload into my YouTube account, but I restart very soon.